Hi everyone, Ezekiel O'Callaghan here with Raptor Chatter, here to tell you about a new kind of dinosaur egg that was actually discovered coming from Utah, named Stilotuberolithus storsi. Coming from the Kaiparowits Formation of Utah, the name actually tells us a lot of different things about how it would have looked. The name comes from Latin, with stellar meaning drip and tuber meaning bump, with uolithus being a common name that is attached to different egg genus, or essentially oo genuses, because oo is egg. Now, the fragments that are known would actually show that these small, bumpy eggs wouldn't actually be that large, only about 17 millimeters across at the maximum, with the shape of the egg overall being more circular or ovoid, helping to essentially change how long it would have actually been. The researchers were also able to find some of the pores that actually went through the eggshell, and found that many of these were branching, much like modern bird eggs are. However, unlike bird eggs, a lot of these came through the nodes, and these nodes are very unique, because they are actually set up differently than other known nodes that do exist on other eggs that are related to dinosaurs. The fossil egg taxon Choreotuberolithus warrenensis also has these nodules, but they're built fundamentally in different ways than this new taxon is. In the eggs of Choreotuberolithus, the crystal lattice that helps make up the egg structure is more or less homogeneous. Essentially, you can see distinct bands that expand into the nodules. However, this is not the case in Stilotuberolithus. Instead, in Stilotuberolithus, the nodules have distinct crystals that make up the nodules that are entirely separate from the rest of the matrix of the egg. So this shows how even with very similar adaptations that evolve on the eggs, there's still different pathways to actually reach those kinds of different constructions and those different nodules that do exist. And so even though the exact reason these nodules evolved isn't quite entirely understood, it does help to show that A, dinosaur eggs were far more diverse than we may have previously thought, and B, there are different pathways to try and reach the same conclusions for what's presumably the same purpose, although more research may show that that's not the case. Hi everyone, and thanks for watching. This is the first part of a series that we're going to be doing that's going to be supplementary to the month in reviews, where essentially we're going to have more content in these smaller videos so that you can skip around in the month in reviews, and so that the month in reviews can actually be shorter, as I can just reference back to these videos in case someone is particularly interested in a single subject.